Hello, everyone. Sargon, Destroyer of Worlds here, and welcome back to another episode of Timberborn. Yes, we are back. We are back here in Beavertown. Dawn is upon us, and we have about a day before a drought arrives. So we have a few things we are going to do, but we're in pretty darn good shape here water-wise. Today's episode, we will be focusing on starting a new district, but we're also going to try to clean up a few things and get a few things prepared for the future, and we will see how all that goes. But as you can see, plenty of water, plenty of development. We will get all our explosives here. Yes, a bit of movie magic there with respect to the thumbnail from the last episode, but yes, we have some explosives placed, and we might even have to redirect this bridge here, at least temporarily. Maybe explode this, so then we can also get a channel, or get the channel deep here as well. So I think that's something we will also work on. Sunrise, beautiful day, beavers are out to work, it will be glorious. Now, I think let's get out of here, this mode here. Let's come over here, and we will add, I think, another log pile storage, because we have so much lumber here that is just not being processed, and I think it's because there's no place for it to go. You can see this has 19 of 20 logs, so that will certainly be a big, big help. Now, if we do look at District 1, we do have a couple unemployed beavers. That's fine. We've got 5 kits coming up. That's fine. We have currently power for days. Oh, no, we don't. The winds start to slow down. So 526 out of 880 demand. I don't know if we're going to get to this episode, but at some point we are going to have to see if we can resolve our power issues. Because we can just keep building windmills. But I think we need to look at harnessing more of the river power. Because if you do look, this is all the water that's currently leaving the map. And I think we can find ways to harness that a lot better. Okay, so we do have our log pile being built. Oh no. Oh no, don't. Oh, this is... They're going to presently move stuff from one log pile to the other, which we don't want to do. So maybe if we reduce the desire to 0, we'll at least stop doing it. Guys, I this isn't a government project. I don't think... Okay, you fill that up. Let's see what all these beavers do. Because they basically moved a whole lot of lumber from one side of the street to the other. Okay, perfect. So with that being said, I think we'll set that to none as well. Hopefully this will prevent them from just moving things around once all this is full. Because I just want them to fill things up. So let's look at our other lumber piles. Set that to none. These are currently empty. But this is full. I just don't want them to spend time moving lumber from one storage unit to another. Like, oh no, okay. They're actually doing stuff with the lumber. Where are you guys going? What are you guys up to? Where, oh, where are you? Okay, no more. Maybe that was the last call. I think we're fine. Okay, I think we're fine. Now, what we should also be taking advantage of here, because I do have some unemployed beavers here in District 2. And actually, let's take a quick look over at District 1. We are going to come in and rename District 1 Beavertown. This is going to be the main city here. But if we come back to District 2, if you guys do have a name for District 2, please leave a comment down below, open to suggestions. I have a couple of ideas, but I would definitely appreciate your input into this. You know, sitting up on a slight hill next to some floodgates, a lot of water being dammed around it. So if you've got ideas, please please put them down below. Okay, so while that's underway, let's come down here, turn off our water view. We're going to have to be careful. We have a drought incoming in 4 days. We will remove the path network here. And we will come into our landscaping tools and place some dynamite here. And I do want this prioritized. And the reason being is I think what we're going to do is temporarily and maybe permanently move this path over here so that we can then get the explosives underneath. So that is something we have on our to-do list. So other than that, what is this? I think it's because this is full. Yeah, and we're going to have to do some things to fix our storage problems because, boy, do we have storage problems. Okay, this construction lacks materials. It's just all our explosives here. So we're fine. So actually, let's have a look. Let's make sure we are prioritizing things here. So if we look at Beaver Town here, District 1, I believe this is paper. We do have plenty of paper, but we have such low power. So we're going to pause. I think these two paper mills, because we have this one operating down here, where right now we have enough supply for the demand, although that's about to change. And then how's our gears? We've got lots of gears. So let's turn off at least this gear workshop. Grist mill. We have lots of flour, so we'll turn off one of those. In fact, we have three grist mills up here, so let's turn off this one as well. So that should help. But we'll have to see come morning. So we lost some beaver power, so those were on. What else can we do up here? We do have the explosives factories, which I do want to keep both running. So we'll see how this works out for us. And if we come down here, we're about to lose a bunch of power. So we will turn off, I think, that gear workshop and I think that lumber mill. So hopefully that will keep things going very efficiently. Speaking of efficiencies, let's come up here. We're going to raise that to full height. Oop, actually, we want to do it the other way around. We want to come up here. Put that to full height. Keep an eye on our water here. So this is why I have floodgates on both sides. I did receive a comment on a Reddit post of suggesting just putting dams here, which can work. But the hope is to try to fill this up, which you can't easily do with the dams. Because I can lower these all the way down. And I might be a tad too late for this to work. Just make sure, did I actually raise these? Yep, they're raised. Because you've seen previously, I've raised these all the way up to get the water going. And I think we are probably a tad late in the drought season. Yeah, so I'm just going to raise these up to keep all the water in here that we currently have collected, but that is why I have a floodgate. So floodgates at the top and floodgates at the bottom here. So, but it did not work out this time because I was a tad late, although we should be fine. Okay, so before we get started on this new district, what else, if anything, do we need to look at accomplishing? That's funny where that will stop. We'll unfortunately lose some power there. But we currently have 300 demand and 160 So these guys provide 50-50. How's our gear status? We have 72. We'll risk it. We'll risk running it like that. Ooh, speaking of running. Oh, we got rid of these pumps. But we will turn off these pumps here. We have 1,200 water in Beaver Town. So that is fine. We should also just check on District 2. 770 water. We're fine. Oh, I do want to raise this up. Let's raise that all the way up. Keep what water we have in here. And we have... Oh, go back to District 2. We have plenty of food. Lots of carrots. Ooh, a lot of grilled chestnuts. Ooh, and tons of grilled potatoes. So that is... Oh, that is also good. Now, what is good? We've got all our dynamite here, so we can detonate this. Away we go. Beautiful. So I think we will get our beavers very busy on building a new platform across, which will likely just become the new platform, but we'll see. What do we need here? Rotate around. Yeah, it should be too deep. There we go. There we... Oh, sorry. Whoa. No, that's wrong. Wrong. It is 3D. Let's delete that. There we go. So we do need to build a staircase here. And we need to add paths all the way across. So these beavers are really, really busy. Awesome sauce. We'll eventually have to figure out how we're going to handle this. Likely the same type of thing that we'll have to do here is, and maybe we can just move the path coming straight across. Maybe that makes the most sense once all this is mined. I mean, landscaped professionally. Okay, so yeah, we're fine here. Oh, one thing I do want to do is I want to come in and turn on the forester here. Since I actually reactivated the lumberjacks, which we probably have one too many. If we're going to have a double lumberjack, I think we'll put it over here. So let's get rid of one of these. I think we'll just wait for all the logs to go. So we'll pause one of the lumberjacks. And we will come and place another lumberjack over here. Looking good. So there we go. Okay, so new district. I think we can get started on that. And what I want to do is come over here. And for a couple reasons. And reason one, reason two. So we will soon run out of scrap metal from where we're currently harvesting it. And we also have this underground ruins, which I would love to get to. And I think as well, we can have some fun damming or at least controlling some of the water out of here. So let's work towards this. So if we come back, and we're going to do our beginning trick as well. Oh, that's already almost completely built. Amazing. Working hard. So we will come and place, well, we might as well, I think I'd like to put this back here anyways. So we're going to put the staircase here. And the reason why is that's just a straight shot across. So it's just material. What's the big deal? We'll run a road up through here. And in fact, yeah, what we're going to do is we are going to place a couple of log pile storages so that these can get started to be filled. And what we really have, we do have these on desired. So we should hopefully begin to see them actually shifting resources as soon as this wooden staircase is built, which should be momentarily. So Well, we're coming to the end of the day, so I guess they'll start that tomorrow. So the other thing we can do, now that all this is built, we can come in and demolish this. And I think we just need to demolish here. Yeah. We'll also get rid of the path there for now. Come back into landscaping and get more explosives. And they should be able to reach. So we're going to have to eventually get rid of this path. Yeah, they've got... hang on, let's come to our district center. Where are you at? Yeah, it's definitely near the limit. This is very red. So we'll have to be mindful of that. So let's see, as dawn breaks here, whether or not they start taking supplies from these log piles and transferring them over here. Oh, not connected. Oh, no. Okay, hang on. What? Oh, I'm missing a path. There we go. Now, my pretty little beavers, will you come over? Yeah, so they're they're going to build them first. Yeah, that's kind of important. So we should hopefully, yeah. So they're going to start moving logs here because they're being called for as desired. There's none desired here, here, or here. Although they will begin to fill up once these are full as well. So they're primarily, well, they haven't taken them from here yet. They're just taking them from here. Although I'm sure they'll have to come and grab them from here as well. So beavers very busy logging our chestnut trees. At the forester planting the maple seedlings again. So all is good. All is good in District 2. Okay, so the other things that we need to start mapping out is where are we going to place our new district center? And I think where it makes sense is somewhere up here. And the question is exactly how do we want to run it? So let's get the road up to here for now. And I think we can start placing a few things. I think we can get a large water tank. Might as well get started off with that. We can also come into housing. Now we haven't unlocked these, so we have 5,700 science. Let's unlock the double lodge as well as the mini lodge. So the mini lodge, it fits one little beaver. Double lodge fits six. It's also up top. And then we have the triple lodge. So that inhabits nine. Now, I think what we can do is have a bit of fun here. We can build, I think, some storage on the bottom. And then let's come into our housing. And how many beavers do we really need over here? So that's nine. Versus six. So it's funny, that will actually do 12. It's the same. My math right? No. Yeah, 6, 12, 18. And so that is 9, 18. So that is the same number. You know what? Let's go with the triple lodge. And I think that's probably where we'll cap out a lot of this. Now, the reason why I also want to go with the triple lodge is I do want to come in, and they're going to start with some leisure. They're going to get a... Oh, I was hoping to center that. Oh, Now, I play City Skylines, and this would be like, this is where Move It would really come into play. I don't know. So these beavers are really hard at work getting this district set up, which is good. So let's get a few other things on the go here while we ponder how we'll do leisure. We do need some drop-off points. So I think that makes sense. We can put two here. We have the lodges being built. We do need a way up there. So how would this make the most sense? Well, the easiest way would be simply to come and put a staircase here. Maybe here. We can do that here. And they can get access right there. So as soon as that gets built, we'll mark that as a high priority. Is that outside the range? Oh no, they just don't have gears in District 2. So does District 2 even have gears? And the answer appears to be no. So this is also an opportune time to kind of clean up some of our routes. I'm not really certain whether it's really necessary to have duplicates. I don't think that makes things more efficient. So Beavertown has been sending a lot of stuff over. Now, we don't have plank production. Beavertown does not need to really send any logs because they're self-sufficient here. So we're going to remove the logs, but the planks will come over, and they don't need grilled potatoes, but we'll allow them to continue to send carrots. So if we come back over here, we've really cleaned out the number of routes that we have available. So we are going to send over some gears. But I think what we'll do is we'll come back to the district limits over here. And we're just going to put a high of maybe trying to send 30 over. But as well, and this is something we'll have to spend even more time on. In terms of Beavertown, we want them to keep at least 30 gears within Beavertown. So before they actually send any over. Now we have 70 gears in Beavertown, so that is absolutely fine. So that should hopefully allow things to get built. And I think we're going to have to let some water in here. But actually, where this is really going to become advantageous, we'll let the game continue to run, is let's now remove all that pathing. We'll finish with our landscaping. I want this as a high priority so that we can get more water down here. And then at the same time, we can start getting our landscaping tools here. And I think we can get rid of the path here as well. And then we'll leave the staircase. Will we? Do we need? No, that staircase is really no longer going to be useful. So we can get rid of the staircase as well. But let's come in and place those. Yeah, we'll have to leave one set of staircase coming down for now so that they can remove all of this. Although, So I think we'll actually remove. So we're just planning as we go here. Let's remove. Hang on. Let's make sure we're only removing this. There we go. Then we'll come in and get them to place even more of these landscaping tools. And I think we'll go... this far? Why not? Actually, we can go all the way. We're going to get them to remove this as well. So come back. This will be glorious. This is finishing off what we started last episode, and I'm very quite excited for this. Excuse me. So we will remove the staircase because that one won't be needed. Actually, in fact, I think we can also get this one done. So as soon as this one's placed, we can remove the staircase. Make sure no beavers are trapped down here. Okay, so we're going to remove it. And then we will place one here. Market's high priority because I think they can reach down one. And then we can set all that off. And it's going to be glorious again. Truly glorious. Yes. Did that get placed? Almost. All right. So let's pause. Take a nice little screenshot. Come out of that view. Hit detonate. And let's watch things go. Beautiful. Beautiful. That was amazing. Okay. So this has now allowed water throughout the entire channel, which is going to work out very well for us. Now, I do want to come back in and rebuild the platforms here. So I think these are three. Yeah. There we go. So we want that. It's a bit of extra, but you know what? I like the aesthetics of coming just straight across. Okay, so this is built. There is no water here. Well, that's obvious. Okay, we'll slow things down. Wow, we're already through that drought. And how are we doing? Everything is... well, we lost some stuff here. So this should help that. But I'm also tempted... I think we'll see through next drought. If we can hold enough water back in through here... because we did lose the ability to get water because of how this was designed. And obviously not allowing more water in. But I think we can fix that. But otherwise what we'll do is we'll blow a channel here to get water underneath. But I think that's fine for now. Okay, so if we come... what are these guys... oh! Whoa, 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 whoa. Okay, let's set these to none. What we want. So all this to none and that to none. So not allowed, none desired. So in here, we're going to want... yeah, because they're not going to have any farms for a while. So we are going to need... carrots. There we go. So we are going to say that... well, we can fill this entire one with carrots. Let's make sure we've got plenty of carrots. And this one will be grilled potatoes. And they can fill this one with grilled potatoes. So that will help solve that. And can we get Oh, it needs a path. So if we got a path here, and if we just prioritize this building by haulers, we'll get some water in here as well. Yeah, you can see they're starting to fill that up. We're taking it from here. Oh, which means now that this is built, been demolished, we can now come in and place our water pumps that we had here previously. How did I have? Oh, I need to put in some platforms again. So I need to put in 3 platforms, come back into our water pumps, and there we go. So that is all good. And that way we can get water pumped out of this when we need to. And we'll be able to hold a lot more water in here once the drought's over, which it almost is. So all that we really need to do, let's just check to see how we did down here. We actually pumped out all the water here, which, oops. But that's fine. Nothing died, which is good. So the water's coming. So as soon as the water gets around the turn here, we will restart. Yeah, we can then restart or open up our floodgate system over here. Just take a moment and see it coming down here pretty fast. And then once we get that done, we will get building what we want over here in our new District 3. I just don't want this to overflow and flood our agriculture area over here, just the aqua farming. And we might have a relook at this to see what we can do about even storing and holding more water. I've got some plans. Now, whether those plans will actually work is completely unknown at this time. Okay, so we can now drop this floodgate to 0. And we'll come over here and drop this floodgate to 0.5. Like I said before, you could just use this as a dam. But if I actually got things done right, I could have filled these entire areas to the brim just before the drought. But with how long our drought lasted there, we were fine. Okay, so we have... we'll slow things down. And we can now come in and decide where we want to put our new district entrance. I think here works. So what we'll do is... we'll come in, we'll pause, we're going to delete this path here, and we will add a new district gate, and we will come in, oh, it's right here, and put our district center. I think what we'll do is we will put it up against the water here. There we go. And then we'll just extend our path. That works. Oh, and what we do need to do, if we need to come back to Beavertown, and we need to set up some routes. So we have carrots and planks and gears going to District 2, but we need to set this up for our new District 3. So in the left one over here, we're going to send them carrots. We will also set one up for grilled potatoes. And I think as well, let's have a look at District 1. We have sunflower seeds, bread. So we can send a lot of food over here. Send some bread. And we can send some sunflower seeds for now. And then in this one, we will send them logs. And we will send them some planks. And I think we'll send them some gears just for now. Okay, so with that, we're going to come over here into our distribution limits. We really don't want berries coming over, not that we have any. Once maybe some books later on. Bread, I would say 35. Carrots, set that for 50. We send some other stuff over later. I think we have to get some more distribution capacity. Oh, we actually don't want any flour coming over. No cattail root, no chestnuts. Maybe some explosives later. Gears, I could say maybe 15. Grilled chestnuts, let's do 35. Grilled potatoes, let's do 50. What else do we have here? Grilled spatterdock. Yeah, we'll have to set some up later. We do 15 here as well. Logs, we can say at least 100. Maple pastries, we'll do 15. No maple syrup. Maybe metal blocks later, so we will set up 20. Paper, none. Pine resin, none. Planks, let's do, let's say 40. No potatoes. We don't need them to send any scrap metal. No spatterdock. Maybe 30 sunflower seeds. Treated planks we might need later. Water, let's keep at least 50 over here. Wheat flour, none, and wheat, none. So that will hopefully keep things well balanced. And it's something we'll have to do with the other districts. Now, I would love to see this hold back even more water. So what happens if we muck with our floodgates and raise these to 1? We'll have to keep an eye on it. What are these? These are at 0, so maybe we can get these to half. Hopefully that has the same effect, just that we will get this filled up more before it starts spilling water over. Oh, well, speaking of water, let's get these pumps going. Okay, well, wow, we're really low on water. So this is not overflowing. It looks like we're balanced, which is good. Now look how much more water we have in this reservoir. It is a thing of beauty. Loving it. Just loving it. Looking good. Okay, so District 3 needs some work to do. It's got, well, actually it needs people. We evicted everybody once we set up the new district. So once again, if you guys got a name for District 3, well, that might take some time, but, you know, we got a lot of ruins here. We've got this underground ruins. And I think we're going to look at damming this up to at least get some water filled into this. So at least from a water perspective, District 3 can become a self-contained unit. So where do we have a bunch of beavers? We don't really have any massive unemployment. But let's come over maybe to District 1 because it has the most number of beavers. And we will migrate to District 3. Well, this is what we can do. We can send over all the kids. Hey, kids, congratulations. You're going on an adventure. Then I think we'll send over 4 adults. So we'll migrate those over to District 3. And those four adults can currently all be builders. So plenty of spot for them to live and grow and have fun and all that stuff. Now, speaking of fun, we need to ensure that they also have the ability to have water. So let's come in. And maybe here. Okay, we're going to come down here. And we are going to build staircase, staircase. And then they'll come up here, here. And we will put a staircase system in. Extend the path network over. And the reason is, we are going to try, we'll try, I know we can do this. We're going to put in triple floodgates, I think. Is it here? Where do we want to do this? Think here. Well, floodgates here are wasted down below. So, levy. And then I think what we can do now is triple floodgates across, and then a single leg gate. I think we need to provide a way for our beavers to get down. So then staircase, staircase. And then they can come in and hopefully get there. Now the goal of this is to push water into this area. So let's get things set up here. We will, I think, have, we'll start with one water pump. We have room for a second if so desired. Not 100, you know what, let's give them a nice leisure spot. And maybe we'll come in and we will put a nice campfire up top. And then they can come up and access this campfire from a path here. There we go. I think that works. Wow, we're... Okay, it's all the kidlets going. What do we do? What do we do? What do we do? Something to do? Anything to do? So they're hard at work. They'll definitely need the leisure activity. They're going to love this campfire. But let's also find a way to get a rooftop terrace. Now, I think we're going to need more storage. So let's come in. And let's play with this a bit. Come into storage. Let's also unlock the large warehouse for 250 science. And this may be what allows us to maybe center some things. And speaking of center, I would so love move it. But I think we can do this and this. Let's pause things for a moment. Because I don't want them to start constructing these things yet. In fact, and it's a good thing, because I do want, I think, back this off the road one. So let's delete those. Back to storage. Once again, let's just pause. And then we can put a leisure. Hopefully this works. Rooftop terrace. Oh, it's three wide. Oh. Why did I think it was two? Okay, so that doesn't work. See, good thing we didn't have them starting to build these. So come into storage. Well, this is going to be the same problem we've had with the other ones. Unless we... Can we get creative? Will this... Can I get... No, I won't be able to get that centered. Okay, so we're going to have to abandon that particular plan, but we will need more storage. That's a given. So I think what we're going to do... And how much storage will we actually need for a lot of these things? Probably not a lot. So we will continue to use maybe the small storage. We'll back this off the road. And then I think we can get away with putting some storage back here. Yeah, we can do this, and then we will put a nice rooftop terrace access here. And then I think what we can do as well, as these kids grow up, they're going to need jobs. So we will put a builder's hut, and we will do a hauling post. So they'll need a way to get up there. So I think what we can do is this. In fact, we'll provide nice, great access both up and down. This will work out quite nicely. And maybe we'll do some funky stuff in the back. But also, let's make sure we set these to none. Okay, grab this. Set to none. None. And this way we can try to control what's coming into these things. Okay, so that is all under construction. I think I do want to prioritize. Come back and turn that all the way up to the top. I want to get... Okay, that has been built. So we'll get this built, this built. And we can prioritize... All those have already been built. That's good. Which means we will then prioritize all of this. Let's just make sure District 3 is not about to die on us. No, we're good. In fact, we've got gears, we've got planks, we've got scrap metal. Oh, we have a stranded beaver. What? Where? How? I am... Like, you're... Dude! I honestly don't know. You're kind of just meditating there. I really don't understand. Like, I've tried to save, and I think I've been successful in saving every beaver that has ever been stranded. And I just don't know what to do about you. I don't know how you've gotten yourself there, dude. You're old enough. Yeah, I think you're just going to die, my dude. I'm honestly, Zal, I don't understand. And you're kind of killing the vibe here. No, okay. I really don't know if I could say, like, because you're floating. I don't know how you're stuck. So, okay, so we're getting near the end here. So let's kind of just move away from Orzal. They're finishing this off. I should get them to prioritize. Oh, is that just too far from you? Oh, because we need to get this stuff built. So that's a priority. This is pointless, so we might as well pause this. Builder's hut is built. That will get built, which means we can put a whole bunch of beavers to good work here. Because we have 4 unemployed beavers. Right? District. Why? Oh, I need another path. Like, why aren't you clicking on his District 3? There we go. So it's Builder's Hut for District 3. We have Rooftop Terrace. Everyone is going to be happy. They're already chilling, getting a social life on the go. Okay, so I do want to check, did I send scrap metal? So I'm not sure why. Why do we have scrap metal in District 3? I'm not sending any. So I have gears, planks, logs, carrots, grilled potatoes, bread, sunflowers. I don't have a scavenger flag yet, so I'm highly confused as to how we got scrap metal. Oh, you know what happened? Okay, I know what happened is when I set these up, some scrap metal must have been stored here temporarily. Okay, with that being said, what we will do is, because we will be collecting scrap metal here, is we can have this one as scrap metal. We will connect a path underneath, and away we go. So a lot of happy beavers over here in District number 3. So we are successful, and the key things that really helped, you know, we really got District 3 off to a great start by having our large water tank built, some storage for food, and our housing already pre-built. And then, of course, having some log piles here as well, pre-stocked. So that's pretty good. And then we have our 2 drop-off points. So this will get things in. So we have space for gears and planks to come in and food to come in before it's picked up and moved to our storage. Now, I actually think we should set some of these other ones up as well. Let's do that. So we will come in none. We will make this bread. We will connect that one. And here we will make this sunflower seeds. And there we go. So I think, let's double check. For everything we have incoming, we have space for carrots, grilled potatoes, bread, and sunflower seeds. We do not have any storage for planks or gears, I do not believe. So what is here? That is for scrap metal. So let's put planks. And then we will put room for gears here. That way, everything that's incoming has a proper storage. Ooh, you know what's nice? We've left ourselves a little nook here to send a staircase up. That's gonna be nice. In fact, let's continue our niceness. We'll leave that space. We will definitely put a staircase here then. We'll have to eventually get over to the scrap metal. This is being built slowly, because they can reach it. They just too far from builders. Oh. Oh. Let's fix this. That needs to be a staircase as well. Oops. Let's put that on high priority. So the builder should get right at this. Yes, okay. So this is good. This is all very, very good. So it's a very successful day here in Beavertown. We've resolved a few of our issues. We've started rebalancing some of our supply shortages or storage areas, I should say. We got this all exploded and full of water. It's well balanced. We have district number 3 well underway. It's a nice little community over here, which I don't think will grow too much more. We'll have to see whether we add any more housing, but we do have, 17 beavers, and there's room for 18. There's 5 kids that are gonna grow up. Yeah, there's 1 free bed. But there's only gonna be so many jobs, and a lot of it's either gonna be building and scavenging. So I don't think we need to grow this community anymore. So, but with that, I think we will leave it here. If you did enjoy today's video and you got some great value from it, please hit a like button. And don't forget, I am looking for names for District 3 as well as District 2. So please provide your input. Oh my goodness. Let's fill up this basin again. Oh my goodness. Missed that floodgate. So as you can see, the water flowing back in. Oh my goodness. That was nearly devastating to District 2. So with that said, and with that fix done, we will see you next time. Have a good day.